Cyclones. AT&T Stadium here in Lubbock. Brian Custer along with Robert Smith. Dean Blandino is with us as well. 64 degrees. Expect a high of 70. This is a big one. Iowa State second in the conference tie with Texas. Just a game behind Oklahoma and Baylor. The conference record. And there's Tech at 1-2, 500 overall. Tech won the toss. They've deferred. So Iowa State will get the football first. Trey Wolf will kick things off. Back deep. Command no longer for the Cyclones. 18th meeting between these two schools. Tech leads the all-time series 11-6. Tech 7-2 against Iowa State in Lubbock. But it's the Cyclones who've won the last three meetings. And we're underway in Lubbock. And the Cyclones will start from their own 25.
Please join us in cheering on today's Taco Bell and T-Kid. Beckett too good. And runs to pick up today's kicking team.
And we'll get our first look at the sophomore, Brock Purdy, the Big 12 passing leader. 11-4 as a starter, 8-2 against Big 12 teams. He averages 301 yards a game through the air. That's seventh most in the FBS. Tops again in the Big 12. Breece Hall, as Robert talked about, will start in the backfield. And Hall gets the carry. Left side. Give him 5 yards, brought down by Broderick Washington. Campbell loves what Michael Petway's doing lately. Arkansas transfer had career high in catches and yards last week. Always a big play threat on that outside.
Yeah, he certainly is. And Deshaunte Jones, no catches a week ago, still leads the team in catches with 37. He had a couple 8-catch games earlier in the season. Look for him to get the ball in a lot of different ways today.
As Deshaunte Jones, they joined him in the backfield, but over the middle, and it's caught by Tariq Milton. Milton has got a first down. 13-yard pickup. Texas Tech's defense, well, they let. Ball fake to Hall. Over the middle. Caught. Milton. Brought down at the 15-yard line. A 39-yard pickup.
Nice throw here by Purdy. Gets it over to Marcus Fields in the coverage. Just drops that thing in perfectly for Milton. Really hit him in stride there, and he got his feet caught up.
Quick score to the outside to Deshaunte Jones. As the Cyclones go with a little tempo, Jordan Brooks with the stop, giving it 7 out of 28. 21 touchdowns, 6 field goals so far this season when they've gotten inside the red zone. They're looking at 2nd and 5. Purdy swings it out, but incomplete. He was trying to get it to Petway. But hey, the Cyclones, just 3 and out drives this season. Purdy over the middle again to Milton. And he's upended at the 10, but we got a flag.
Pass interference, offense, number 11, 15-yard penalty. It's third down.
And on that one, just kind of stood in the way.
Big penalty. Pushes him back 15 yards. Purdy, receiver screen to Deshaunte Jones. He picks up a couple. Braden Narvison will come in for the kick.
Well, this one's going to be into the wind, too. These flags are flying hard south. You saw that kickoff sail into the end zone.
This will be from 41 yards out. He's made one from 45 this season. And it's no good. No score here in Lubbock. Iowa
Iowa State had the football first, drove down the field, but missed a 41-yard field goal. And here's Tech's first offensive opportunity. Here's Jet Duffy, the junior, making his third start of the season. Six of his career. He's thrown for over 350 yards in back-to-back games. First Red Raider to do that since Patrick Mahomes. And R.J. Turner.
R.J. Turner.
Picks up eight. Second and two. And again to the outside to Turner. That's a first down for the Red Raiders. Duffy will look to the side to get the play.
Part of the chess match there. Sometimes defensive coordinators will change. Sometimes they won't.
Duffy. Plenty of time. And he's going to keep it and run. Forced out of bounds by Mike Rose. So we take
Duffy made the right decision that time. Didn't see what he wanted down the field. Did not try to force the ball. Just took off and ran.
So Roderick Thompson gets the carry. Thompson keeps his balance. He's got a first down. And he's past midfield. He's in Cyclone territory. Marcel Spears makes the stop. And they go with tempo at the Cyclone 49. And again to the outside to Turner. And that's one of the things the Red Raiders said they wanted to do today is get that ball on the perimeter.
Yeah, absolutely.
He'd been nursing an ankle injury. Gets his first carry. Ankle looks fine. Picks up about eight. Brexton Lewis makes the stop for the Cyclone.
In this Iowa State defense.
There's Eisworth. He's the captain of the defense. He's been nursing a shoulder injury. That one's incomplete. He's looking at McLean Mannix. Austin McNamara will punt things away for Tech. Deshante Jones. And it goes into the end zone. Second offensive series here for Iowa State. They went 53 yards in the first one. Failed in the red zone for just the second time this season. Purdy to Breece Hall. Right up the middle. There's some hitting going on here. State is averaging 45 points in three games against Tech in the Matt Campbell era. These Cyclones have put up at least 30 in their last six games. Here's Breece Hall again. And Hall close to a first down. Rico Jeff can see what Breece did last week against West Virginia. Breece Hall at 132 yards. Had a career high 26 carries. Got an injured player on the field. It looks like the left tackle, Julian Good-Jones, and he's one of their best up front, Robert.
Yeah, he certainly is. 43 consecutive starts. Didn't start the first game of his freshman season, but he started every single game since then. Tackle replacing Jones at some point.
Third and four. Purdy over the middle. Complete first down. Petway. He brought down at the 35-yard line. That's an 8-yard way.
Whatever it takes.
Purdy again, back to pass. Plenty of time over the middle. And incomplete, but there's a flag. Zach McPherson was in coverage. He was looking at Sean Shaw Jr.
Compliment McPherson on his coverage in this one. I don't know about that, especially thrown from the back. I don't know what that official saw on that play. You know, what kind of contact? I just don't agree with that call. I just don't think there was any kind of impact or interference on that one. I was going to compliment McPherson because from our angle from the press box, you could see that he was not interfering. He was not pushing before the ball got there. He may have just been throwing the flag as a reaction to the receiver falling.
That's DeJounte Jones. And forced out of bounds by Thomas Leggett.
But not with DeJounte Jones.
Purdy over the middle to the tight end. Dylan Sainer. And Purdy, he is just so comfortable in that pocket. 19-yard pickup. He is 7 of 8 for 92 yards, Robert, already.
And defensive coordinator Keith Patterson said, he's just too poised. Brock Purdy's too poised. You have got to get people into his face. You have got to affect him in some way. It's just so calm back there. Even with pressure around him, he just has at this innate sense to move away from the pressure in such a natural way, keep his eyes downfield. A nice little pop pass executed by the offense right there.
They've talked about trying to get some pressure to move him off the spot. Oh, comes firing in there. What a play by Evan Rambo. Cyclones go with three tight ends here. Purdy looking to the end zone. Throw caught. Touchdown, Charlie Kohler. 24-yard strike by the Cyclones.
Boy, and Kohler, his numbers this year, I believe that's 20 now, 20 out of 24 catches that have gone for first downs or touchdowns on the season. And they like this matchup with their tight ends getting downfield, matched up on McPherson on that play right there. And McPherson, you're playing a tight end like that, you cannot let him get behind you. He's got his eyes back to the quarterback. Purdy makes a great throw, getting it up high enough for Kohler. And McPherson just rushed in position to make that play.
The extra point by Connor Azzali is good. You know, Kohler was a high school teammate of Trey Young of the Atlanta Hawks, and he went up and got that one. 7-0 Cyclones here in Lubbock.
Cowboy, you got to see the boots.
Yeah, I got it all. I got it all. That one's on to the outside. Xavier Martin for 10. Scored their opponents 44-17 in the first quarter. Duffy caught. First down.
That slant.
Ah, here we go. Trick play around the outside. Xavier Martin. And Martin hit by Greg Eisworth, the captain of the defense.
Eisworth and Spears combined on this hit. They were just waiting for him. Say, yeah, it's a nice play. Very cute. Get it around to the outside. We'll just be standing here. Boom! Waiting on it.
Duffy, he's going to keep it. Maybe to the line of scrimmage. Lawrence White forces it out of bounds. Third down coming. Keep your eyes on Marcel Spears Jr. He's got three career picks against Texas Tech. A couple of pick sixes. You know, he's been named Big 12 Defensive Player of the Week the last two times Iowa State has played against Tech. And he's your linebacker at the bottom of your screen. Duffy, back to pass. Throwing hit. Ball comes flying out of there, and they say incomplete, that his arm was going forward. He's averaging 44.7 yards a kick. That's the best among FBS freshmen. Cyclones averaging 10 yards a play. Red Raiders just 4.5. Third offensive series for the Cyclones. 2:46 left here in the first quarter. And Purdy, back to pass, and going deep, looking for Joe Skates, and knocked away, and a late flag. Zach McPherson again.
Did he get enough?
There is no foul on the play for defensive pass interference. The contact by number 8 was simultaneous to the pass arriving. It's second down.
So Brandon,
all right, got confirmation from the man.
Here's Dante Jones on the outside, spins. And hit by Jordan Brooks. This Tech squad, this defense, Big 12 leader in takeaways. They forced 12 turnovers.
And risking playing the man coverage here. Maybe a shot downfield.
And that one is caught by Petway. Tariq Melton in motion. Purdy rolls, throws, complete to Breece Hall out of the backfield.
Impressive stats of his in a bit.
Here's Breece Hall, escapes one guy, sheds another blocker.
Breece Hall, the
brought down by Jalen Hutch
from anywhere with just one signal.
How about that formation on third and one? He started in a diamond formation, and then they give it to Hall. Hall. Met right there by Jordan Brooks, right at the first down marker.
A
believe Hall was able to get that one.
Stopped on the play by number one, Jordan Brooks.
And it's going to be the last play here of the first quarter.
This is the end of the first quarter. Timeout.
Tech usually outscores their opponent in the first quarter, but not today. Cyclones with a 7-0 lead second quarter when we come back. Start of the second quarter here at Jones AT&T Stadium. And it was a first quarter dominated by the Cyclones. Red Raiders with just 54 total yards of offense. Brock Purdy, and a tactician, 11-13 for 144 and a touchdown pass.
Purdy second among active quarterbacks in passer efficiency. How good has he been?
Oh, he's been pretty good. Here's Breece Hall. Trying to get around that outside. Zach McPherson forces him out of bounds. Boy, this is his longest run of the day, just 6 yards. Breece Hall with 7 carries, 16 yards. Purdy looking for the tight end, Kohler. Got him to the 20, Kohler. Brought down by Douglas Coleman, but at the 5-yard line. A 48-yard pitching catch by the Cyclone.
Patterson brought the blitz, defensive coordinator. They took a chance. Coleman was matched up there against Kohler, and there, once again, you got a height mismatch. 6'1" for Coleman, 6'6" for Kohler.
Purdy, Breece Hall. And he's met at the line of scrimmage.
They like their height advantage on the outside. It'll be matched up man-to-man coverage.
This is Nwangu. And brought down behind the line of scrimmage by who else? Jordan Brooks. He's usually a guy they'll look to. Purdy throwing to the tight end. And it's Kohler again. Charlie Kohler, man who leads the Big 12 when you talk about tight ends and catches, receiving yards. He's done it again.
You see him matched up here, and it's just so difficult. You're talking about a 6'6" tight end. And he makes a move there, able to get free. Leggett had no chance on that one, the defender for Texas Tech.
Extra point is good, and Charlie Kohler now has 4 touchdown catches on the season, 7 in his career, and the Cyclones are up 14-0 on the Red Raiders. On Henry, back deep for the Red Raiders. And once again, the Red Raiders. We'll start from their own 25. Cyclones tied with Texas going into today. Game by just 56 total yards of offense. Meanwhile, the Cyclones have rolled up over 200. Duffy back the other way. Eric Izukama.
Rarely see them out of place, and they rally to the ball extremely well. Changing up the look on the defensive front this time. They're waiting late till after Texas Tech makes their offensive call.
The jet, and it's incomplete in the hands and out of Travis Coots.
But Miller, nice job breaking that one up right there.
The punt. Good pressure by the Cyclones. Deshante Jones, that's a go. Takes a Tech bounce. And rolls out of bounds at about the 21-yard line. The Cyclones have got the rock again. Purdy, he's had plenty of time. Swings this one out wide open as Breece Hall down the sideline. Hall cuts back to the middle. And Hall is loose. Breece Hall finally brought down the 15-yard line by Zach McPherson, but not before he goes 62 yards.
And you see late movement along that defensive front from Texas Tech. And what happens there, guys just get a little bit confused. In coverage there, somebody clearly was supposed to have Breece Hall as he went into the flat there. And he does a nice job cutting this one back across the green. Almost took it to the house. Nice catch and run by the true freshman.
And once again, the Cyclones are inside the red zone. Purdy is thrown for 260. And he's looking for more to the end zone. Petway, touchdown, Iowa State, 17-yard strike. And the man who leads the team in TD catches has added another one, his fourth of the season.
Another great throw brought by Brock Purdy right there. It's his man, Petway. Not a chance in coverage on that one.
Well, we told you about Brock Purdy at the top. He is Iowa State's career leader in completion percentage at nearly 70%. And he is 15 of 17 here already for 277 and three TDs. He just took this Cyclone squad 78 yards in two plays. And Robert, they did it in 52 seconds.
This Texas Tech offense has got to get something going on this next drive. They have got to get some points, at least get some possession, get that defense a rest. Extra point, no good.
Yeah, he missed that one. Went a little left. But Petway got the touchdown catch. And Broxy, that's a pretty pass. Cyclone. 20-0 our score here in Lubbock. As Iowa State just went 78 yards and 52 seconds. And I said it at the top, you know, Cyclones are averaging 45 points. In the last three games they faced Texas Tech, especially under Matt Campbell. This Cyclone offense has put up at least 30 points in their last six games. Paddock, the kick. This is Henry from his own end zone. Across the 20. And brought down around the 25-yard line. And let's get a quick game break in. Here's my man, Mike Hill. Maybe Yo said, I got to get this offense to start quicker. They need something. Here's a pitch and catch to R.J. Turner.
And it was R.J. Turner. Take advantage of the cushion this Iowa State defense is giving.
Duffy's going to keep it. And maybe a yard.
Great defensive play right there. And you're not always going to make the tackle, but you can affect the ball carrier. And that's exactly what Rose did on that play. You get a guy like Jet Duffy, who can run, to have to cut that one back. You got your boys inside to make the play.
Here comes a 0-3 here on third down. Are the Red Raiders. DJ Vasher at the top of your screen, just one catch, swings that one out. Bahamian, another flag comes flying in. Brandon Cruz.
Personal foul, illegal block below the waist, offense number 86, illegal crackback. At the distance of the goal, it's third down.
And call that on 20. Duffy, over the middle, complete. Turner. And he's about 5 yards shy, though, of a first down. Deshante Jones standing at his own 30. Calls for a fair catch. The Cyclones will start from their own 28. 41-yard punt. 20-0. That's our score. Last three possessions for the Cyclones. They've gone 80 yards, touchdown, 80 yards again, touchdown, 78 yards, touchdown. And over the middle, that one's too high. He was looking for the Michael Petway.
Middle, late, and it forces a high throw on that one. Makes Purdy miss Petway.
Meanwhile, that guy's been the story of the first half. A couple of touchdown catches, Robert.
That really has been. just had him matched up against defenders that couldn't handle the size. You can see right there, Kohler able to get behind the defender, up over defenders, and it's been different guys back there. There's just really nobody back there that has been able to affect him after he's caught the ball. I mean, getting hit before the ball, if you're Brock Purdy, you can just throw it high enough. It's like, again, that analogy with the basketball player. You got tall players playing in the post. Can't put a guard in there to defend them because the pass could just come in just too high to affect it. Of course, fortunately in football, you can affect them after they catch it. That's what the defenders have to try and do.
As Kohler in motion. And Purdy was looking his way, but finally had some pressure, had to get rid of it.
Higher than he wanted to once again, causing the incompletion.
Just a 4-3 and out this season for Iowa State. That's the fewest. This is Sir Roderick Thompson. And Thompson keeps the legs turning. He's got a first down.
Ball.
Duffy, play action to Thompson. To the outside to T.J. Vasher.
Finds a space on the outside. Just haven't taken advantage of it up until there.
That's Thompson again for another first down. Marcel Duffy swings it out. Thompson spins. Braxton Lewis makes the 4-yard pickup. Duffy again, quick pass. Rigdon to the outside. He's a couple of yards short of a first down. Great eyes
into tight coverage just to try and get it downfield. If they're going to give you the underneath throws and you can stay on schedule like they are right here, second and short, go ahead and do it.
Amon Jean has checked in the backfield. That one's to Ezukama. And Ezukama carrying Cyclones. Driven out of bounds.
Maybe you try a double move.
There's Sean. Eisworth brings him down at the 19. And now Tech in the red zone.
Got a player down for Iowa State here. Blocked by T.J. Vasher on the outside.
Gets rolled up by his own man.
Again, happened so many times.
Zone. Red Raiders, 13 of 14, 10 TDs so far this season. Receiver screen, T.J. Vasher inside the 10-yard line. Duffy swings it out. Thompson met by Mike Rose.
The play forced the cutback into another waiting defender.
You see Osworth, the safety, creeping over, but they're going to hand it off. Thompson cuts back and brought down at the 6. Duffy, handoff. Touchdown, Red Raiders. Sir Roderick Thompson, his 6th of the season. 1st and 10 for the Cyclones. Jones in motion, and he's going to look to Jones, and he makes the catch, and he's out of bounds. Purdy, over the middle, complete. Sean Shaw Jr., averaging 11 yards on first down. Here's Breece Hall, and it's another 11, plus down the sideline.
Tech defense, you see those kind of mistakes. We saw it from Bruffy, senior from Texas Tech, on that offensive line. It's usually the younger player.
Under pressure is Purdy, and he still got it off to Breece Hall.
That was
Jordan Brooks came flying through there.
A blitz and pressure with Brooks. It's able to get home and affect Purdy.
Purdy is now thrown for over 300. Spins out of the pocket, looking. He'll keep it. And a run out of bounds. He's been huge. He's in the slot. Bottom of your screen. Deshaunte Jones in motion. Purdy's thrown for over 300. He averages 300 yards passing. That pass caught Milton, but he's short of a first down. Jamarcus Ingram, big tackle. Here comes the field goal unit. Keep in mind, Narveson missed the field goal from 41 yards out in the first quarter. They've missed an extra point. This is from 42 yards out.
This one's with the wind.
And almost didn't get it off. They throw the flag.
The play clock expired. This is the third and final charge timeout by Iowa State. 30 seconds.
Missed his first one and misses his second one. Will those come back to haunt the Cyclones? It missed two. Jet throwing. Almost intercepted by Eisworth. He's got that sore shoulder, but he almost had himself a pick. 22 seconds left. Receiver screen to Turner. It might just be the last play.
Up, as they say.
Yep.
And that's the end of the first half.
That's the first half. 20-7, our score here in Lubbock. We'll send you out to Los Angeles for that State Farm halftime show. Well, it's homecoming here at Texas Tech, but a Cyclone has blown through the first half as Iowa State with a 20-7 lead. We begin the second half. Brian Custer alongside Robert Smith, and you look back at the first half, it was really all Iowa State, especially offensively. Brock Purdy threw for over 300 yards. They got 345 yards of total offense. And he's thrown to seven different receivers.
Boy, he has been. Let him throw back and or sit back and pick apart your defense. And it wasn't until that second quarter, about midway through, that they were able to start getting that pressure. But you can see, if he gets that kind of time, he's got all kinds of targets in that receiving core with those tight ends that he can hit. And they loved that matchup, their wide receivers against the secondary of Texas Tech. But then Texas Tech started to get that offense going a little bit. Our youngster, Sheroderick Thompson, able to get some runs. But offensive coordinator David Yost did a nice job mixing up run pass.
So first and 10, it's Thompson. Spins, brought down by Braxton Lewis.
Oh, that one, BYOB, be your own blocker. Lewis was in the hole there as a free runner. Thompson does a nice job spinning and making a miss.
Marcel Spears comes firing through the line, and they wrap up Thompson. Third and three. The jet throws, caught. R.J. Turner makes the catch. Should be enough for a first down.
He was going to take a pop on that one. Still delivered a nice ball to the outside.
Duffy. Again to the outside, and Thompson.
That's just where you have to be patient as an offense and as a quarterback.
This is Dalton Rigdon, and Rigdon dies for a first down.
Double move.
Again to the outside, again to Rigdon, and Rigdon. First down, Braxton Lewis makes the stop. And Jet escapes. Keeps it. He's got a first down, and he's in Cyclone territory.
Bobby Millen didn't wrap up.
Ron Shine has checked into the game. Duffy, ball fake. Over the middle, caught. Ezukama. Brought down at the 20-yard line.
Ezukama allowed him to catch and run on that one.
Shine gets the carry. Left side, lowers the shoulder, Big third and one. 11th play of this drive. To the outside. Ezukama. Things up, getting the ball to the edge. But none of it matters unless you convert. You'd much rather get six than an attempt at three. R.J. Turner at the bottom of your screen. He's number two. T.J. Basher on the inside, and here's a flag.
Ball start. Offense number 70.
Basher at the bottom of your screen. This is Sean. Sean dragged down by Justin Bickle. Offensive line and on the outside with the bubbles, which has really gotten him down the field. Duffy looking at Basher and Turner. Looked for Turner, but it was picked off, but in, out of bounds. Tavon Kyle made the pick for the Cyclones, but he's out of bounds.
Boy, it was a one confident, not cocky, making too many mistakes like that.
Duffy dumps it off to Shine. Shine inside the five, but no more. But here's Trey Wolf. This is from 22 yards out. Hit three field goals last week against Baylor. And drills another one. Here's Brock Purdy. How about a half? He had 308 yards through the air.
24, and of course, he had the performance, record performance, earlier in the season, 21 for 22. The game was just so accurate. And again, it's all about the pressure. Keith Patterson, you got to find ways to try and dial it up.
Flips this one out to Breeze Hall. Hall, stiff arm it down the sideline. Breeze Hall, gone, is gone. 75 yards. As Douglas Coleman tried to make the stop, and Breeze Hall wasn't having it.
See why they're so excited about this young man. 26 carries a week ago. Just turns on the Jets, and just enough of a move and the stiff arm there to break free. And then the acceleration.
We'll see if he does step out of bounds. Looks good.
Yeah, that's good.
Can't tell there.
Can't tell
looks
there.
Looks good. I think he's good.
Yeah, they look good. 10 carries, 112 yards now for Breeze Hall.
Is under review.
They're going to take a look at this one, but I don't think they're going to see anything on any of those views. Certainly, that would be clear and convincing.
So it has been confirmed. Touchdown for Breeze Hall.
Well, the call officially was stands, so they might have had some doubt there. They couldn't say confirmed from any of those angles, but of course, called inbounds on the play, nothing to overturn it.
Hey, Breeze Hall, 84 yards, basically the first few games of the season, and he's put up well over 200 here the past couple. Connor Sally missed that extra point earlier, knocks that one through. Well, Iowa State had a drive that went two plays for 78 yards earlier. Breeze Hall goes 75 yards in one play. They're up 27-10. 27-10, our score. Jet Duffy flares this one out. It's Roderick Thompson. Thompson back to the line of scrimmage, and that is it.
Anderson was fighting to the outside, forced that one to cut back.
That one batted and almost intercepted. Tucker. Duffy rolls out, flag, keeps it, first down, Duffy, across the 40.
At the distance of the goal, it's third down.
27-year-old rugby player converted to a football player.
All because of one call, that's why coaches harp on attention to detail. Getting that hand outside the frame on the hole.
This is Jones from his own 30. Look at the swivel.
That's a lot of moves. A lot of moves to go 7 yards.
27-10. Our score here in the third quarter. You know, Breece Hall, first Cyclone true freshman, but back-to-back 100-yard rushing games. He's got 112 here today. Had 132 last week against West Virginia. Three tight ends. Whoa! High snap. Purdy controls it and turns trouble into something. 3 yard pickup.
That was an interesting. Guessing that was not a called Brock Purdy run.
Again, the three tight ends set by the Cyclones. Second and seven. Purdy, pressure up the middle, throws incomplete. He was looking for Dylan Sainer. Got a couple of touchdowns already. Purdy, flag over the middle. And guess who? Kohler.
Looks like an illegal shift.
Offense number 88 is moving forward at the snap.
So they bring him inside of the formation, and they're going to try and get a matchup here. He just starts moving a little bit too soon towards the line of scrimmage.
Jones in motion. Right to DeJounte Jones. Couple of blocks. Cuts it back inside, and Thomas Leggett makes the stop. 4 yard pickup. Joe Rivera will cut things away to Zach McPherson back deep for Tech. Just a second three and out. Red Raider puts stuff to the outside. That's perimeter. Now downfield. And too hard, too high for McLean Mannix.
Missed Mannix.
Back to the outside. Ezukama.
See Mannix coming right back on this one, getting a good block on the outs of five.
That's caught. T.J. Basher. Fumble the football. See, if Iowa State did, they recover inbounds.
Yeah, I think that was the issue when they had a body part out of bounds. And that's the punch.
Arnold Azuna.
Right there from Azuna. Basher wasn't taking care of the ball, leaving too much space out there. Oh, no, that's out of bounds.
Mm-hmm. Neither team with the turnover yet. Running hard. Tayshaun Henry. Hard running. First down, a whole lot more by Henry. Puts his shoulder down. A sophomore out of Houston.
And because of this defensive structure for Iowa State, back to that in a second.
As Henry, first down. Zuna makes the stop.
In and run support, and they just have not been able to get there in time on the edges in some of these plays.
There's a first down.
Like a textbook.
Duffy, that's complete. Mannix.
Duffy's pass complete to number 13. Unit 5 brings up second and 5.
Again to the outside, Keyshawn Carter.
Part of that team.
Duffy. Complete. R.J. Turner.
Don't want to settle for three on this one. Like they had to do the last time.
Duffy looks to the sideline for the play. Under 3 minutes left in the quarter. Good move by Shy. Spins out. Turns nothing into something. Marcel Spears makes the stop. But no. Shy again. And it's a first down inside the 10-yard line. And they're just pounding it. 3 yard pickup.
Delay your cut as long as you can.
Duffy keeps it. Duffy. And pushed out of bounds.
It'll be just short that ball before going out of bounds.
Shine gets it. Hit right at the line of scrimmage at the two. Fourth down. rebound coming for. So Roderick Thompson comes into the football game in the backfield. Dasher at the bottom of your screen. Duffy gets the play. 5 seconds on the play clock. In the quarter. He throws the fade. Fasher, one hand, and the flag. First and goal. Sir Roderick Thompson in the backfield. Fasher again at the bottom of your screen. They go to Thompson. Thompson. Touchdown. Red Raiders.
Ooh, how about those Badgers? They got a big one in Columbus.
Your hometown.
Yeah, C-Bus is going to be lit.
I know a little bit about that town, too, but it's your hometown.
Absolutely.
First down. Purdy rolls, throws, complete. Deshaunte Jones.
Heck was able to do there, though, and they picked up right where they left off in that second quarter, really mixing up the run and pass well. And now we're going to see they're going to have to keep bringing the pressure. They have not been able to consistently stop Brock Purdy in this pass offense without the pressure. You got to take your chances.
Here comes pressure on Purdy. And throws it up and incomplete. Ian Campbell told us about this Iowa State team. He said, we've got to finish. And no one has finished better than the Cyclones. Lead the nation. 82 points they've scored in the fourth quarter. Their plus 56 advantage over their opponents in the fourth quarter leads the nation. Best in the FBS.
And here comes the pressure again.
And caught. Coming back for it is the Michael Petway.
And take a look at Brock Purdy on this throw. You can see him bring the pressure. And he knows he's going to take the hit. He's got Rico Jeffers bearing right down on him. Had to change his arm angle. Still able to deliver the ball accurately, even though he could not get perfect throwing motion. Great job all the way around by Brock Purdy.
Just the fourth hit on Purdy here this afternoon. 10-point lead for the Cyclones. Texas Tech 3-0 at home this season. Hall wrapped up by Jordan Brooks.
Anything but a hand or a knee is down. The elbow clearly down there before the ball comes out.
You're right.
But the referees, and, you know, this is something that Tech struggled with.
Ruling on the field of a fumble is under review.
Last one, your Texas Tech.
The play, runner was down before he lost control of the football. Ball be placed at the 45-yard line. It's second down.
Second and 11 for the Cyclones. Still no turnovers. Petway in motion. Trips at the bottom of your screen. Purdy looking at Petway over the middle. And broken up as Rambo comes over the top. Kohler in the slot. Purdy looking. Throws. Too high. Picked. By who else? DeMarcus Fields, who came up with the fumble recovery that was called back.
So,
Jet Duffy now. Turner, about a yard shy of a first down. And this Tech defense now with 13 takeaways. And especially the last four games. They lead the Big 12. Meeting between these two schools. First time they met, 1967. Tech won it 52-0. Iowa State and Matt Campbell have won the last three meetings between these two schools. Here's R.J. Turner.
Boy, Spears took a shot at that one, just missed the tackle. Cyclone 24. Duffy throws.
He was looking at Vasher. Vasher hadn't even turned yet and had that ball.
Or if it was actually supposed to be a double move there.
And that one. The Thompson, he hadn't turned around by the time that Jet Duffy let that one go.
Yeah, screen blocking. And Jet Duffy had to get rid of it.
Trey Wolf from 42 yards out. Trey Wolf missed it. Here's Brock Purdy. Threw that interception. And their last offensive possession. You can see what he's done in the second half compared to the first. Here's Breece Hall. Wrapped up by Douglas Coleman. Pounds and leading the country in interceptions. Here's Breece Hall again. And Hall's got a first down. Jordan Brooks forces him out of bounds.
Survive, but maybe even thrive with the blitz.
Hall again puts his shoulders down, but he's met right there by Brooks. And Reyes left in this one.
This one may be offensive interference on Petway. A little push off. See everybody running back.
Pass interference. Offense. Number 7. 15-yard penalty. Second down.
But that didn't look like a whole lot. It looked like the defender just kind of lost his balance in the break.
Second and 24. Purdy steps up. Keeps it. Maybe a yard. Ram under 9 minutes. High snap. Hall. And a good tackle by Jordan Brooks. Punt this thing. Rivera will punt it away. Zach McPherson. From his own 28 and tripped up.
We've been talking about it all day long. Some sort of fake bubble, maybe. Coming on this series, you want to try and get one bit of the defense overreacting.
Duffy again. That one to Henry. Lawrence White makes the stop, maybe a 2-yarder. Duffy flushed. He's gonna throw and bat it.
Spears almost got it.
Sell Spears. Marcel Spears, 10 tackles, 1 for loss. Pass breakup. This guy's been defensive player of the week. Last couple of times he's faced Texas Tech. Fair catch. Cyclones have the football. A little over 7 minutes left in this game. Game, and it came by the freshman Breece Hall. Breezing down that sideline, went 75 yards to the house. Hall ties his career high in rushing. He's got 132 yards on 15 carries, averaging 8 yards a carry. That's an All-State mayhem moment, and it came in the third quarter. Cyclones up 10, 7 minutes left in this game. And Hall's got the rock again. Look at our game summary, Robert.
Yeah, this Iowa State offense kind of had their way for most of the first half. And in that second quarter, Tech started to get that offense going. Held the ball for most of the third quarter. They've got to make some plays here, though, obviously down 10 defensively. Got to find a way to come up with a stop.
Purdy under pressure, throws, man, wide open, Twink Milton. And pulled down at the 29-yard line by Jamarcus Ingram. But not before the Cyclones pick up 45 yards.
In the middle of the field, been a real problem all day long for this Tech defense. See Jamarcus Ingram on the coverage. Doug Coleman trying to get over from that other safety position. Classic split safety look. How many times have we seen completions in that area today? It's a lot of speed in that receiving core for Iowa State, but a lot of size as well. They were able to hit tight ends early.
Milton's got 99 yards receiving. Hall up the middle. Breeze Hall just breezed right into the end zone again. Touchdown, Iowa State. 30-yard touchdown run for the freshman. A new career high in rushing.
Good call there, Iowa State. Offensive coordinator Tom Manning gets an extra blocker, motions tight end into the formation, which creates another gap. Defense not able to respond. Hall able to take advantage of it, getting into the end zone.
Extra point is good. Breeze Hall, 236 total yards of offense, but it started with this catch by Tariq Milton. That one went 45 yards, and Breeze from 30, 34, 17, Cyclones. Pretty good basketball team. Oh, put it on the ground, but he was down. Looks like it was Sirajic Thompson. To the outside, and dropped by Dalton Rigdon. Duffy throws a strike. Turner.
Marcel's time hits him on the deep in or dig route.
And down the sideline. He's looking at TJ Vasher. That was Anthony Johnson on coverage. 76 yards. Those 11 catches, career high for him. This is Ezukama. Inside 5 minutes left. Amon Schein gets the carry. Schein across midfield. And a first down. Duffy. Under pressure. Spins out. Keeps it. He's got a first down, it looks like.
Second loss of the season being out of conference to Iowa.
Henry. Right side. Henry. Down at the 22-yard line. Jack, he'll take off. Brought down at the 11. Duffy, under pressure, and sacked.
Well, Mike Rose comes late on the blitz that time. Late on the blitz. And again, once blocking up front gets defined, you bring that extra rusher, nobody there to pick him up.
First sack of the day for either squad. Here's Duffy, swings it out. Henry. Oh, Charles Eisworth. Mm. I'll tell you what, they have him listed at 6 feet. He's not 6 feet, but boy, he can lay the wood, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does. You can see Henry getting airborne there. Once you get airborne, hey, it looks good in slow motion, but you lose all your power, and Eisworth comes up there with a big hit to finish off the play.
Duffy steps up and set. Mike Williams. To the air, to the top, looking for Keyshawn Carter, and a flag.
Number 10, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
So first and goal, Duffy, touchdown pass, TJ Vasher.
Himself's a good one.
Rizal again, the first true freshman Cyclone history to go back-to-back 100 yards. Goes right out of bounds. That'll probably be a flag.
Offside, number 9. That penalty's declined. Kickoff out of bounds. Penalty's 5 yards from where the ball went out of bounds. First down, Iowa State.
Wins the game and Certainly Illinois had their share of struggles this year, but Wisconsin, even in the win against Northwestern.
Here's second and eight. Continues. That's another first down.
Best formation in football.
Yep. They'll take a knee. So Matt Campbell would now go 10-0 in the month of October. Since 2017, he's been perfect in this month.
Thanks, guys.
His Cyclones have now won three straight. And Matt Wells and his Red Raiders suffer their first defeat here at home. They're now 3-1. As Brock Purdy, 23 of 32 for 378, three touchdown passes, and just one interception. And he was pretty good, especially in that first half. Kohler, a couple of touchdown catches.
Nice job sitting in there on some throws, even when he got some pressure in his face. Once that pressure got dialed up, he had to make some contested throws. He was still able to do it. Certainly one of the more underrated quarterbacks in all of college football.
The Matador Song.
Another solid performance today.
Through for Robert Smith. I'm Brian Custer. Final score, 34-24. Iowa State with the victory here in Lubbock. After this break, we'll get you out to the MLS playoffs. Seattle taking on FC Dallas. Thanks for watching.